Welcome to Grace Notes. This is Alan Button. At the end of what no doubt will be a week that goes down in the history books, the takeover of the Capitol building on Wednesday, January 6, 2021, has caused us here at the station to think about, as we regularly do, some of the music that we play. And we've pulled together some music that we think is particularly meaningful in light of the events of this week. We're going to start with a song that Johnny Cash wrote in 1974 after the Watergate scandal led to the resignation of President Richard Nixon. Across the world, the United States has been known for its red, white, and blue colors. Red symbolizing valor and bravery, white, purity and innocence, blue, vigilance, perseverance, and justice. And of course, the 50 white stars on a blue field representing the 50 states in all their diversity. The 13 stripes representing the 13 original colonies. I expect it's fair to say that for all of us this week, we in one way or another have been asking ourselves the question, will our flag and all it represents meet the challenge? Here's Johnny Cash with Ragged Old Flag.
I walked through a county courthouse square. On a park bench, an old man was sitting there. I said, "You."
That was Ragged Old Flag by Johnny Cash. Joining me now is our producer of Grace Notes, Christina. Christina, welcome.
Good afternoon, Alan. Thanks for having me. What a week we've had, huh?
For sure, yeah. And as you and I have talked about the program today, it occurred to us that there's another song that was born out of tragedy, but has broad implications in terms of the lyrics. American Pie by Don McLean, released in 1971. You want to say something about it, Christina?
I think this week has made us look at this song and other songs a little bit differently and in a different light. You know, this song was written about events that happened in 1959, and there are pieces of it that really feel like they ring true for me today and after Wednesday's events specifically.
Yeah, it related to a plane crash that killed Buddy Holly, the Big Bopper, and Ritchie Valens. But, you know, when I hear the title American Pie, I immediately think of how America has long been characterized as the place where motherhood and apple pie reign supreme. And I guess the question we're asking ourselves is whether American Pie is now off the menu.
Mm-hmm.
The song, in many respects, of course, is really just a poem. And although it may have been motivated in the author's heart and mind by certain events and ideas that he had, all good poetry, I think, lends itself to interpretation by the reader, the listener. And I'm struck by a number of the lines, including these where McLean writes, "The halftime air was sweet perfume. While sergeants played a marching tune, we all got up to dance, but we never got the chance because the players tried to take the field. The marching band refused to yield." Makes me wonder, in light of this week, who the players are, who's the marching band. There's been some refusal to yield and an inability of certain players to take the field.
It's food for thought.
Let's hear it. American Pie by Don McLean.
A long, long time ago, I can still remember how that music used to make me smile.
Boys were drinking whiskey and rye, singing, "This'll be the day that I die."
Well, Christina, we've lined up another song that my wife suggested to me this morning. "Hole in the World" by the Eagles. Why don't you introduce it for us?
This is a song, like you said, by the Eagles that was released shortly after 9/11, and it talks about the feeling that we all had during that time that there was a hole in the world. And what happened on Wednesday feels a lot like what happened on 9/11. I think almost all of us are going to remember where we were when we heard the news or were watching the footage of what was going down in the Capitol. And those images are burned into our minds, and they're going to be in history books for centuries to come. the uplifting note, I think, of this song that makes it so special to us is there's a hole in the world tonight. Don't let there be a hole in the world tomorrow. And I think we all need to decide where we go from here.
Well said. Let's hear it. Hole in the World by the Eagles. During World War One, in 1914, as history has recorded, there were a number of unofficial Christmas truces along the Western Front. And John McCutcheon put that historical fact to music. He sings about how the German and British soldiers got together, played some soccer, shared stories and cigarettes. And it occurred to us in thinking about this week that a truce like that is the ideal, that war is not where we want to be. And we thought as we wind down the Christmas holiday season, it might be well to hear that song again and think about if maybe in 1914 that kind of truce was possible. Maybe the hope of Christmas is still alive and well. Here it is, Christmas in the Trenches by John McCutcheon.
My name is Francis Tolliver. I come from Liverpool. 2 years ago, the war was...
That was Christmas in the Trenches by John McCutcheon. Christina, anything you want to say by way of reflection on that song?
Yeah, I think it's just really a great message for all of us. These soldiers could put aside such huge differences and find common ground. And I'm hearing a lot today about friends on social media or just in real life that are completely removing other folks from their lives because they don't see eye to eye on politics or what have you. And I really think that's not the answer. Now's the time to find common ground and respectfully talk about our differences and find a way to have some sort of truce and friendship.
I think, Christina, actually, that's a great introduction to the song that we're going to end with, and that is My Beautiful America by North Carolina's own Charlie Daniels. Speaking of finding common ground and overcoming differences, it's a song that celebrates the diversity that is America. And in fact, it brings us back to where we started. It ends with the Pledge of Allegiance to the flag and the republic for which it stands. As I said, Christina, we'll end there with the hopeful questions and words of Charlie Daniels. You good with that?
Sounds great, Alan.
Thanks for joining me today, Christina.
Of course. Thank you for having me.
Let's hear it. My Beautiful America by Charlie Daniels.
One nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.